The last question I have here is something that is very, very difficult, takes a lot of intensive practice, which is, let's boil our findings down, as I've tried to do as I narrate this video. Boil it down so you can explain it to an intelligent person with no training in statistics. So, don't talk about rejecting the null hypothesis or failing to reject the null. Don't talk about statistical significance. All that stuff is going to go meow for people who do not have training in this kind of information. Even for some people who have had training in it, they might forget. So, an effective way is to just say in plain language, state what your findings are. So, these grad students were less happy than the general population. And in the natural light condition, they were happier than when they were indoors in fluorescent light with no windows. And they also rated themselves happiest when the wallpaper color was a white rather than a very loud color like red. So something like that, anybody can understand without necessarily knowing all the statistics. But a nice thing about JASP, a good reason why I like JASP, is it makes it very easy to do all of these tests. And the whole reason for JASP to even exist in the first place is the creators wanted to make it easy to run Bayesian statistical analyses. So when I go up here and I select t-test, I focused thus far on one sample t-test, paired samples, and independent samples. These are the classical tests that anybody learns in a psych stats course or statistics for behavioral sciences course and so forth. But these Bayesian alternatives can be helpful as well. So I'll run one example. I'll run a Bayesian independent samples t-test, so we'll use the lighting condition, natural versus fluorescent, and we'll do happiness at week one. So if you'll recall, I'll scroll back up and find, here we go, we got happiness in week one, we have a t-value of 3.09, this was significant with a p-value of 0.003. We had a pretty large Cohen's d value here of 0.92. So if I scroll back down here and look at the Bayesian independent samples t-test, what is this BF10 thing? Why is that 11.34? What does that mean? And what's this error percentage? That's a whole other discussion right there, but put very simply, this base factor 10 is a ratio. It is the likelihood that this result occurred under one hypothesis versus a different hypothesis. Now that can be null versus alternative, like what we're traditionally taught, but an advantage of Bayesian procedures is you can compare two competing alternative hypotheses. So if you've designed your study to test, let's say, I'll go to the classic example, if you're testing whether a drug is effective or not at treating something like depression, you could have one condition with a test of the medication, and you could have a different condition where people have a placebo. And then you can compare those two, and you don't have to compare null versus alternative. You can compare alternative one, the drug is effective, versus alternative two, it's nothing but a placebo effect driving the improvement that we see. So the BF10 is the likelihood of what we traditionally consider the alternative, the second hypothesis, versus the first. So it is approximately 11 times more likely in this scenario that the natural light condition is actually causing higher levels of happiness than the fluorescent light condition. So that sort of a hypothesis test and a effect size measure all rolled up into one. There are advantages and disadvantages to using the Bayesian test versus the classical t-test, but simply put, if you're going to go back up here and say, oh well, we have a significant difference here at the 0.05 level, and Cohen's effect size is large, that takes some explanation as far as what that means. Versus here, you can say, the data we have here were about 11 times more likely to have occurred if natural light actually makes people happy. And here we're testing, you can specify a hypothesis, you can specify whether you're doing a two-tailed test or a directional one-tailed test. Here we think that group one is going to be higher than group two, so I can change that to a one-tailed test, and there you go, you can see that the base factor value is now 22. So if I want to make this comparison, and I predicted a priori that natural light was going to make people happier than fluorescent light, I can say, well, that's 22 times more likely than that fluorescent light makes people happy, or that there's no difference. That's pretty easy and pretty intuitive to understand, and JASP makes it easy to run that kind of analysis as well. So, there's a brief summary of how JASP works, how to install it, how to run different kinds of tests. There are a couple other tests that I just didn't cover here, but you can explore that for yourself. And I very highly recommend JASP if you're going to do any data analysis. Another alternative, maybe you've been using SPSS for 20 years and you've got all your data saved as a .sav file. Well, how are you going to get that out if you don't have SPSS on your computer? Well, you can do that with this program called PSPP, which is a free and open source program. If you download that, it tries to duplicate some of what SPSS can do. I found it to be kind of glitchy, and it lacks some of the features that SPSS has. It lacks some of the tests. It lacks, once again, the ability to edit your graph. You can't do that in PSPP either, but something I found PSPP to be very useful for is if I have an SAV file, I can open it with this, then I can take the data and copy it into Excel, save that data in Excel as a CSV file, and now it's easy to just upload into JASP. And if you're wondering what PSPP looks like, there should be pictures on here somewhere. So here's an example of what it looks like. You'll notice that it looks largely similar to SPSS with some things that are missing. Here's variable view. You can see the data view over here. This is what it looks like if you're running descriptive statistics on this big old data set here. Right, so that is how you can open source your data analysis.